Good afternoon, everybody. Again, I was telling the chairman that the problem with the post-lunch sessions are that half of the audience go and the other half try best to remain awake. So please try to be awake. I am Pankaj Mittal. I am vice chancellor of a rural women university. He was drawing your attention to the state universities. Now, this is a state rural women university imparting education from KG till PhD to about 7,000 students. It's a residential university. Half of them stay on the campus, half of them commute. So, but with excellent infrastructure, almost matching any foreign university. So when I speak here, I speak with the perspective of a rural women university. Now, in the morning when Mr. N.K. Sinha was speaking, he was telling that what all technological innovations the country has already done. He spoke about NME ICT, National Mission on Education through ICT. He spoke of NPTEL. He spoke of e-libraries. We do have now e-journals, e-books. We have even virtual labs. That is, the people, students can do their experiments online on the labs which are situated far away in IITs or very big research laboratories. Those experiments can be done online. We have Sakshat portal. We have e-tutorials in them. We have e-content. When the private sector talks about something like 50, 60 courses, we already have 1,200 courses in engineering and 3,000 courses in social sciences and sciences. We have, I mean, not only in the university, we have a service called DTH, that is direct to home, where the student can go to home and access channels for knowing about various courses. And then we also have Akash tablet, which he also told that now it has a capacitive screen and camera and all that. Now, all this technology is already available, but how many of us are making use of it? And what is the, how this technology is helping our higher education system to improve the quality, to improve the access, to improve the equity? Now, when we talk of higher education system, we basically say that higher education system faces three E problem. Three E's are expansion, equity, and excellence. So these three E's our higher education system is facing. We'll first come to expansion. When we talk of expansion, our GER is 12%. We want to make it to, say, 21% by the end of the 12th plan. And when we talk of increasing the GER, what best possibilities are there? We can increase the number of universities and colleges, but our government doesn't have that kind of money to have those many universities and colleges. We can increase the intake capacity of the existing universities and colleges. Again, money is required, and then the question of quality comes in. We can have private-public partnership, but the most effective of that would be careful amalgamation of conventional and distance mode of education, and that is where the technology helps us. That is where the technology helps. And if you are thinking of open education or distance education of the past, where the lessons used to come by post in our homes, which were mostly in print format, today we can have a different type of distance education thanks to the technology. We can have video lectures, we can have CDs, where instead of getting the print material, students can get lectures, video lectures delivered by the best professors of India or the world. That can exactly sort of, we can change our entire scenario of higher education system as far as distance education is concerned through technology. Then if you talk of equity, there is a lot of divide in our country. There is a rich-poor divide. Rich have access to better institutions, poor do not have that access. There is a rural-urban divide. Rural institutions are not that good as urban institutions are. There is a divide based on, disadvantaged sections of the society, or even male-female divide is there, even minority divide is there. But technology does not recognize any divide. For technology, everybody is same, whether he is located in a rural area, whether he is located in a backward area, whether he is poor, rich, male, female, minority, anything. Technology does not recognize all these things, and that is how technology can address the issue of equity in higher education. So access, that is expansion, as well as equity. Now you come to excellence, that is quality. Quality is again a very big issue in higher education nowadays. When we talk of quality, what affects the quality of higher education? First and foremost is teachers. I mean, there are good teachers versus bad teachers, or no teachers, as Dr. Bandyopadhyay was saying. So there are institutions with good teachers and bad teachers or no teachers. Then how does technology help? Technology can help because we can have video lectures from the best teachers available to the institutions where there are no teachers or bad teachers. Then again, how is the quality affected? It is affected by availability of infrastructure or facilities. Like institution may be having good library, good labs, good classrooms. Other may not be having, and that is affecting the quality. Again, technology can step in. We can provide to every institution, whether it is good or bad, any type of infrastructure in terms of e-books, e-journals, in terms of labs, because I was just saying that if you go to that vlab.co.in, you can access the labs of IITs sitting in a rural college. So all these facilities are there, and we are also knowing that all these facilities can help us to tackle the problems of higher education system. But then why it is not happening? The big question is why. The question is why, and the answer is because of problems of implementation. Like in my university, I have 1 Gbps connectivity, but we do not have internal networking. So when internal networking is not there, this 1 Gbps almost lies unutilized. We do not have those many access devices. We do not have those many computers. And above all, the problem is of awareness. In the morning, they were talking about it, that we should convert this from silent revolution to a vocal revolution. Problem is of awareness. Like, I do talk to many teachers, many students. We have an academic staff college. So we are running orientation and refresher courses in which teachers from all over Haryana and even outside come. When I talk to those teachers, I ask them, do you know what is NMEICT? They have not even heard the word. They don't even know that e-journals are existing. They don't even know that e-books are existing. Not only all this, they don't even know what is GER. And the teachers of higher education, even lecturers, readers, they do not even know what the term GER is. So the problem is more than technology, it is of awareness. We have created all this technology, but nobody is aware of it. Nobody knows how to use it. We held special workshop from InfliMNet to tell our teachers and the teachers from the neighboring areas how to access e-journal. They have just heard of e-journals, they don't know how to access it. And then we have very simply put on the notice board how to access e-journal, like step-by-step procedure, 3-step, type this, go to this, use this password, and then go to this, and then you will have access to this journal. So these small things are becoming a major bottleneck. That is how our technology, even if it is existing, it is not being used by our institutions, just by lack of awareness, lack of attitude to use. So that is foremost thing, and what my maybe punchline would be, that if we want to convert our demographic dividend to knowledge power, we have to market our education, we have to market our technology so that everybody is aware of it and everybody uses it. Unless it is used, creating all this technology of no use. So we have to make our people aware. Maybe we have to have extensive seminars, conferences, workshops, or whatever way we have to tell that it is existing and how to use it. Unless we do it, technology, any amount of technology we create, it is of no use. And the problem is more in backward areas, rural areas, where masses lie. Our higher education system is not in IITs or central universities. It is in state universities, it is in colleges, and it is in places where most of these things are not reaching, and if they are reaching, people are not knowing about it. So if you have to address the masses, if you have to overall improve the higher education system of the country, we have to make people aware of it and make people use of it. So that is the ultimate thing. Thank you. Thank you very much.